I've been hunting for 30 years now, and every opportunity I get to go to the woods is a blessed moment. But now it's more for me to be able to pass on the traditions of hunting, the experiences of hunting to other people. It's about watching the excitement on somebody's face, being in the outdoors for the first time or being on their first hunt, hearing that first gobble on that spring morning, or watching a flock of ducks come into some decoys. So for me, being a mentor, that's what it means to me, is to be able to pass on this tradition, to watch the excitement and relive back when I went on my first hunt and what that was about.
Welcome once again to Turkey Call Television. We're going to be chasing down turkeys. This time we're in South Carolina hunting these hard-headed low country turkeys that I promise you, if you get one, you got to earn it. But the people we're hunting with have certainly earned the opportunity, some of our military veterans, and it also highlights a great partnership. National Wild Turkey Federation is all about partnerships. This organization wouldn't be here without the partnerships that we have across this country, across the world. This one is with the South Carolina Forestry Commission, where they're taking wounded warriors and military veterans hunting. I think y'all gonna enjoy this show. If y'all like turkey hunting as much as we do here, be sure to go to the NWTF's Facebook page. Be sure to share us and like us, and make sure you and your buddies are catching up on all the hot turkey hunting topics all across the country.
For a lot of folks, being a mentor means it may be just that one-time hunt, and there's a misconception there. It's not about just taking them on a hunt. It's taking that person out, showing them how to plan a food plot, putting up trail cameras, teaching them how to call, the importance of firearm safety. You might spend an entire day walking through the woods looking at sign. From different animals, showing them what it's about to scout before you hunt. That's the role of a mentor. It's not just taking them on a hunt. And then once that hunt's over with, you want to make sure that you stay in touch with that person that you took out there hunting. You're going to take them again. If they're looking for another opportunity to go, you're going to be there for them. If they have a question, once they get out there and start trying to do it on their own, you're there for them. Your role as a mentor doesn't just happened the day of the hunt, it carries on.
Well, I'm in the military, in the Army National Guard. My commander came to me and one of my coworkers and said that they had a couple spots for turkey hunts, and me and my coworker, this would be our first year turkey hunting, and he gave us the opportunity and we jumped on board. Started out with orientation. Didn't really have too much experience with turkey hunting or a really good understanding of the birds' social activities and everything. And going through the classes gave us an opportunity to kind of fine-tune some of those skills in order to take out to the field this week. orientation went smooth. I got to meet some great people, other soldiers. Got to bunk with the guys. Great talking about different hunts and everything. It was great.
Looking forward, always a pleasure to be down here with Scott.
After that, they draw who's hunting with who. We have mentors there and guides that are going to take them out. We drew our hunter. And then it gives us opportunity to spend a little time with that hunter and get to know him. These are military guys. You get to hear their stories. And it's really cool to spend a little time with them before we get to go out there in the woods, because you get to learn the person a little bit. Of course, we're in South Carolina and you're hunting an Eastern, and if you've ever hunted an Eastern, you know how stubborn and ornery they can be. And of course, this time of year when this hunt takes place, it's early on in the season. You're still dealing with flocked up hens, flocks of gobblers that are following these hens around. They're still out there trying to establish some pecking order, so the turkeys are still not really right, as people will tell you. That turkey's not right, but it is tough. A lot of it takes some scouting and figuring out the turkeys, and we're there for a couple of days, and that makes it easy on us. You know, a lot of the setups may be in these swamps, and it's wet. So you've got to deal with turkeys that have to work around water and knowing your setup and the lay of the land. One great thing about this particular piece of property we were on, it had just been burned. So it's wide open, a couple of days been burned, and that's excellent for turkeys to be hanging out in. The next morning we got up, weather conditions were right, good and clear, cool. So I had a feeling this ought to be a great day to be in the woods. So we started out getting in real, real early. We had a long road that was carrying right down to where this bird was roosted. So we decided to set up on the edge of the road, put some decoys in there and try to get his attention. He came out into the road. I think he saw the decoys there for a few minutes, and then he cut across the road. And one thing about hunting in groups, always stay close to your hunter. I was set up back to the right. This bird was coming straight to me, but of course it wasn't coming to our shooter.
We want to hear from you. Share your hunting story. Be sure to hashtag it, #MyNWTFStory. Share it so everybody can see it, and who knows, somebody here at NWTF might just send you something cool in the mail.
Partnerships are the backbone of our hunting heritage programs. Without these partnerships, particularly with the South Carolina Forestry Commission, who does a lot of programs just like we do here on the Hunting Heritage Center, it's just not possible.
The South Carolina Forestry Commission is one of the state agencies, and its mission is to protect and develop the forest resources of South Carolina for the citizens of South Carolina. And to do that, we have four primary functions. That would be forest management, forest protection, resource development, and information and education. To do what we do, we have to have partnerships. We have partnerships among other state agencies, but we also have partnerships outside of that, and one of those is with the National Wild Turkey Federation. When we started a program to provide a mechanism to help our soldiers coming back from active duty transition back into civilian life, we needed partners to make that happen. Folks like the National Wild Turkey Federation stepped up immediately and began to work with us to provide seed, seedlings, fertilizer for planting for wildlife and other equipment and those sorts of things and meals for those soldiers when they come in.
The National Wild Turkey Federation is partnering with state and federal agencies as well as the hunting industry folks to try and build these experiences, to have mentors and a ready supply of trained mentors that are available to take out new hunters, reaching out to new markets and getting those people exposed so that we can go into communities where people use food co-ops and they want to have a low footprint for their food and know where it comes from locally. Those folks are people that are willing and interested to get into hunting but don't have any exposure. And so it takes us developing programs like that to get the mentors trained, to make sure that we can hand them off from one organization to another to build multiple touches and get them to the point where they think about themselves as a hunter and then begin to mentor other hunters into the fold.
People are engaged, partners are engaged and are willing to work together. You will see that industry partners are funding R3 programming. We're funding positions, all chipping in money to make it possible to have an R3 coordinator. We're doing research, we're trying things out and seeing if it works and evaluating. There's much more emphasis on data and evaluation and making sure that our programs are producing. In the past, we've just held programs and checked it off the list and moved on. The industry, the agencies, and conservation organizations, that's typically how we operated. But what we've learned from R3 is it can't be that way. We have to evaluate, find out if that worked, if it didn't, tweak it, recalibrate the programs so that they are effective, and then share that back with each other, what we've learned, so that we can all benefit from that.
This hunt is similar to what we do. We introduce new hunters, we get them involved in the outdoors, and it's with particular groups. This particular hunt was with the military. They also do women's hunts also in the spring. So these partnerships are crucial in our mission statement and making sure that we are creating hunters and making these events successful. When I got to meet Michael, I found out that he was a first-time turkey hunter. Never shot a turkey. So that was going to make this hunt really special because of what we're trying to do at NWTF and at the South Carolina Forestry Commission of getting folks involved in the outdoors and taking them hunting. Well, like with any roost hunt, you know, things calm down there for a few minutes and you kind of talk about what the bird did. But then off in the distance, we heard some birds gobbling pretty strong further on down into the swamp. So what we were going to try to do was go get closer to these turkeys and see if we could strike one of them.
We set up, we started doing some calling, and we heard them gobbling. We heard a gobble or two. They kept answering back, and eventually, about 5-10 minutes later, off in the distance, you see a head pop up.
Just hang tight.
But it was awesome. It was seeing it on TV or watching it on YouTube or something like that. It's not the same when they're right in front of you doing it, and you know you're getting ready to take one. So it was pretty thrilling.
You know, for Michael and a first-time hunter, his first experience in the spring woods, he really got a show. Those old three gobblers jumped on that Avian X decoy and went to wailing on him. You know, he was breathing heavy, his heart's beating fast, and of course we were trying to talk him through, hey, pick one out. We only wanted to shoot one, and it was just a great time, and I think he was thoroughly enjoying every minute of it.